So my first tool was a dip pen, which created a very nice distinctive look for the first comic. It had very thick paper cutty outlines. I filled the black shadows, I think, on a computer. Back then I didn't know about tablets yet, so I used a mouse to do the black. It was crazy. It was also my first experience with Photoshop. So it was very amateurish, but I think it was very good for somebody who hadn't learned anything from somebody else. So I improvised a lot. And it was a very dirty business, the dip inks, and I'm a very impatient person, and sometimes I work too fast and too stressed. So it resulted in a lot of, splashes, ink splashes everywhere and on my face and in my hands. And so that was the beginning. And since then I've worked my way through a lot of different brands of fineliners and multiliners, brush pens. And I can say that I still haven't completely arrived, but I've come very close to the tools that I like, which is usually a brush pen for very close, big stuff, and thin fineliners for far away stuff. And I had to find the right brand of fineliner too, because I apply so much pressure that I need a fineliner that can stand a lot of pressure. So I use actually two different brands because they have different attributes. In Austria, I didn't have that much of a choice. There's one art store in the center of my hometown. It's not that big. It's 250,000 people live in my hometown. So there's one nice art store in the center, and they didn't have that much choice. But I did find some that I could use pretty well. But here in New York, I found even better ones, and I can show you which ones I use. I use if that's okay.
Oh, yeah.
I use Copic multiliners for from 0.5 upwards, and down from 0.5 I use microns, because they're very stable. Well, for some reason the Copics are very thin and not very sturdy. From 0.5 downwards, it's really weird. I don't know why. And my favorite brush pen in the world is, oh, there we go. This one, it's Pentel. It's I have had the same for 3 years, and it's still the same quality. And you can put new cartridges into it. It's really good. And it's not super soft, so it doesn't, the tip doesn't, you know, spread when you press. It stays together. But I also needed to find the right paper. Just want to add that I finally realized that very smooth paper is super good if you work fast and if you're more like a nervous, stressed worker, because then the line doesn't interrupt when you draw too fast. So stuff like that. But it really came together in New York, I have to say, because there's much more stuff to choose from, more art shops, and there's more people you can talk about it with. So I use those pencils now.
Yeah.
Because I realized in Austria you can only really buy some with very thin mines, but here you can buy really thick mines, and I realized how much I like them, because I always have the full grab surface.
Yeah.
Yeah.